studying the hadith of thulathiyat nabawiyya, which is a hadith the Prophet ﷺ gave three advices in each one of them. So the hadith of tonight is reported by Imam al-Bukhari, but not in Sahih al-Bukhari. The hadith is reported in his book, At-Tarikh al-Kabir, the book of history. And this hadith is narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. In this hadith, Prophet Muhammad said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَا عَمِلَ ابْنُ آدَمَ شَيْئًا أَفْضَلْ مِنَ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِصْلَاحِ ذَاتِ الْبَيْنِ وَحُسْنِ الْخُلُقِ. So the best deeds you worship Allah with, subhanahu wa ta'ala, after the aqeedah, after the iman, is to pray the prayer and to fix the relationship of the Muslims around you. The prayer will fix your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you do effort to fix the relationships of the Muslims around you and to be a person of a good manner. To be a person of a good manner. With regard to as-salah, our Prophet said alayhi salatu wassalam, إِنَّ بَيْنَ الرَّجُلِ وَالشِّرْكِ تَرْكُ الصَّلَاةِ فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. Between the person and shirk is to neglect the salah and to leave the salah or to reject to pray the prayer. We all knew that the scholars of Islam, the majority of them said, if somebody refused to pray because he is rejecting the obligation of the salah, he is rejecting the obligation, he doesn't believe that the salah is mandatory, or he believes that the salah is mandatory, but he disagree with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why Allah is commanding us to pray five times a day, or something like that. Or you see the salah is not important. So this person is a kafir by consensus. No question asked. Right? The disagreement among the scholars came only if the reason of not praying is laziness. And some people, they are Muslims. They believe in the six articles of faith. And if you talk to them about the Salah, they will say the Salah is mandatory. The Salah is one of the five pillars of Islam. The Salah is the most important action of worship. They knew that. They say we are wrong because you are not praying. The reason they are not praying is laziness. So the majority of the scholars said this person is still a Muslim, but he is the worst Muslim ever. In the Hanbali Madhab, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, even if the reason the person is not praying is laziness, he's still not Muslim. So Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal said, if the person is not praying, he's not Muslim. One word. Despite the reason. The reason is not a case in the Hanbali Madhab. Because he has this hadith, بين المرء وبين الشرك ترك الصلاة. Between the person and becoming a mushrik is to neglect the salah or to leave the salah. And in another narration, the Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, العهد الذي بيننا وبينهم الصلاة فمن تركها فقد كفر. The covenant between us, the believers, and the hypocrites is a salah. Once the hypocrites will refuse to pray, now they made it clear that they are not Muslims anymore. This is the opinion of Imam Ahmad, even laziness. So it tells us the importance of the salah in Islam. As-salatu khayru mawdu'a. Yani the best subject between you and Allah is the salah. Because you represent your iman and your faith and your belief during this salah. Knowing that, and knowing that as-salah purifies you from your sins. We are human beings, we have our weaknesses. So when you wake up in the morning and leave your house to work, throughout the day, you do a lot of sins. When you open your eyes, you see haram, right? And the angel is writing your deeds. When you see something haram, he's writing, right? When you say something haram, it is recorded, right? When you hear something haram and you agree with it, it is recorded. So are you collecting sayyat? So when you come to the salah, see how the process of salah is purifying you and cleaning you from your sins. Here in the hadith, reported in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, in this hadith, Prophet Muhammad said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل فيه كل يوم خمس مرات هل يبقى من درنه شيء. Imagine that you have a river running in front of your house. So you open the door of your house and swim in this river. And you are doing this 5 times a day. Do you think you will have any dirt in your body? No. So it is like that when it comes to those 5 prayers. When you make wudu at home and walk to the masjid and join the jama'ah prayer. So this salah and your wudu will wash away the sins that you committed before the salah. And we are talking about minor sins, not major sins. Because if somebody is committed a major sin, we said this 1,000 times. You need to repent from it by fulfilling the pillars of the repentance. But this hadith is talking about the minor sins. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in another hadith reported in the book of Imam al-Tabarani, he said, تَحْتَرِقُونَ تَحْتَرِقُونَ فَإِذَا صَلَّيْتُمُ الْفَجْرَ غَسَلَتْهَا. So what it means, تَحْتَرِقُونَ, that means you do actions that will cause you to be burned in the fire of hell. Then when you wake up for Salat al-Fajr and make wudu and come to the jama'ah, the Prophet said alayhi salatu wassalam, غَسَلَتْهَا, that will wash it away. That will extinguish the fire. Then he said, ثُمَّ تَحْتَرِقُونَ تَحْتَرِقُونَ فَإِذَا صَلَّيْتُمْ الظُّهْرَ غَسَلَتْهَا. يعني after Salat al-Subh, after Salat al-Fajr, you may do sins and you collect a lot of sins and you deserve the punishment of hell. And so when you come for Salat al-Dhuhr, it will wash it away and you will take this punishment away from you. Then the Prophet said that, ثُمَّ تَحْتَرِقُونَ تَحْتَرِقُونَ فَإِذَا صَلَّيْتُمُ الْعَصْرِ ثُمَّ تَحْتَرِقُونَ تَحْتَرِقُونَ ثُمَّ إِذَا صَلَّيْتُمُ الْمَغْرِبَ and so on and so forth. Every Salah is like that. So the Prophet said in another hadith, الصَّلَوَاتُ الْخَمْسِ مُكَفِّرَاتٌ لِمَا بَيْنَهُمْ. The 5 prayers washes away the minor sins that you commit in between. So you can see how important the Salah for you. Imagine if a person doesn't pray and just collecting sayyat from Fajr to Dhuhr, from Dhuhr to Asr, from Asr to Maghrib, Maghrib, Isha, and he's not cleaning himself from that. The way to clean yourself from major sin is by repenting. The way to wash yourself from people's rights, and pay attention, this hadith is not talking about violations to people's rights. If you are violating others, you need to repent in certain way, different way. But the minor sins that you do between you and Allah, these 5 prayers purify you from it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in hadith reported in the book of Imam al-Tabarani, inna lillahi malakan yunadi 'inda kulli salati ya bani adam qumu ila niranikum allati awqadtumuha fa'atfi'uha. So there is an angel calling in the time of every salah and saying, O children of Adam, wake up and go to the fire that you started and try to extinguish it. Here also hadith from the narration of Amr ibn Murrah al-Juhani. قال جاء رجل إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A man came to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, يا رسول الله أرأيت إن شهدت أن لا إله إلا الله وأنك رسول الله وصليت الصلوات الخمس وأديت الزكاة وصمت رمضان وقمته فممن أنا. So the Prophet said عليه الصلاة والسلام to him, when the man asked the Prophet, O Messenger of Allah, how about if I testify that لا إله إلا الله, and you is the Messenger of Allah, and I pray the 5 prayers, and I pay my zakah, and I fast Ramadan, and I pray the Taraweeh. So, who I am? So, the Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, you are from As-Siddiqeen wa-Shuhada. You will be with As-Siddiqeen wa-Shuhada. Siddiqeen are the righteous people, the truthful people. This is the degree of Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu, for instance. Darajat As-Siddiqiyya. This is the degree of Maryam, wa ummu Siddiqa. Allah said that about Maryam, it was said about Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And al-shuhada are the martyrs. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran that He will gather the martyrs with those who are truthful and righteous, as-siddiqoon, with the believers in general, those who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fulfill the pillars of the deen. Also here is hadith reported in the book of Imam al-Tabarani. He said, خمس من جاء بهن مع إيمان دخل الجنة. من حافظ على صلاة على الصلوات الخمس مع وضوئهن. يعني five things. If you bring them with you to the day of judgment while you are a believer, يعني you will be one of the people of Jannah. He said the one who take care his five prayers and its wudu, he perfect its wudu. Then he said, and you perfect your ruku' in the salah, and you perfect your sujood in the salah, at its time, that means you pray the salah in its time, not after its time, and you fast Ramadan, and you make your hajj, if you are able to do it, and you're doing it, he said, zakiyatan aw tayyibatan biha nafsu, يعني you are doing it from your heart. You don't it where you like it. It's not taken from you by force. You are doing it voluntarily where you like to do it, by your choice. He said, and the one who fulfilled the amana will be one of the people of Jannah. So here when it comes to the salah, he's talking about fulfilling the pillars of the salah, not only joining the salah, fulfilling the pillars of the salah. When you bow properly. When you prostrate properly. When you make your wudu for the salah, you perfect your wudu, you do it with itqan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you one of the people of Jannah. In the book of Imam Malik and Sunan Abi Dawood, the Prophet said alayhi wasalam, خَمْسُ صَلَوَاتٍ كَتَبَهُنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْعِبَادِ. There are five prayers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them obligatory upon His servants. He said, فَمَنْ جَاءَ بِهِنَّ وَلَا مُضَيِّعْ مِنْهُنَّ شَيْئًا إِسْتِخْفَافًا بِحَقِّهِنَّ. Yani the one who would bring these five prayers with him, and he will not يعني lose any part of these prayers because he doesn't care about it. He said, كَانَ لَهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَهْدَ أَنْ يُدْخِلَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. يعني Allah promised him to grant him al-Jannah in the day of judgment. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَأْتِ بِهِنَّ فَلَيْسَ لَهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَهْدَ. So if a Muslim came يوم القيامة and without perfecting his salah, he has no promise from Allah. So if somebody did not perfect his salah before his meeting with Allah, he came to the day of judgment while his salah is not perfect, so he said there is no promise. So what it means there is no promise? يعني Allah may punish him, Allah may forgive him, there is no promise. But the one who fulfilled his salah, properly fulfilled the pillars of the salah, he has a promise from Allah. So that Allah does not break his promise subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the one who is perfect in his salah will have the tranquility in his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows that he's doing his part and he trusts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not break his promises subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the hadith took us to islah that al-bayn. And the Prophet said, alayhi wasalam, when it comes to making settlement among the people and fixing the relationship of people around you, and this is something very important, especially in our era. Prophet Muhammad said, alayhi wasalam, إن الشيطان قد أيس أن يعبد في جزيرة العرب ولكن في التحريش بينكم. In one of the narration, أن يعبده المصلون في جزيرة العرب. So the shaitan lost the hope to be worshipped in the Arab Peninsula after the prophecy of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, but he will be able, he said, fi tahrishi baynakum. That means he will be able to turn the people against each other. He will make people to hate each other, right? To fight and argue with each other. This is the fuel of the shaitan, the inspiration of the shaitan, wal'ayadu billah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, aslihu dhata baynikum. يعني if there is a problem among Muslims, we are obligated, it is a mandatory upon us, is to work to fix the problem, not to cause a problem, to fix the problem. Now we are doing the opposite, right? So sometimes people, they cause problems, right? The command of Allah, that to fix a problem, not to cause a problem. Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the Quran, وَإِن طَائِفَتَانِ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ قَتَتَلُوا فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا. If two groups of Muslims are fighting with each other, try to do settlement and to fix the problem. أَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَهُمَا. Allah also said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ شِقَاقَ بَيْنِهِمَا فَبْعَثُوا حَكَمًا مِنْ أَهْلِهِ وَحَكَمًا مِنْ أَهْلِهَا يُرِيدَ إِصْلَاحًا يُوَفِّقِ اللَّهُ بَيْنَهُمَا. So this ayah is related to husbands and wives. If there is a problem between husband and wife, and you don't want the situation to be worse, so she's supposed to send somebody from her family as a representative, and he's supposed to send somebody from his family as a representative for both of them to sit down together to find a solution. But don't ever live with a problem. If we have a problem, fix it. But don't live with a problem. Some people, when they feel a problem, they watch the drama. they live with it without doing anything to fix it. But the command of Allah in the Quran is to fix the problems. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that is in Surah An-Nisa that fixing Muslims' problems is one of the most righteous actions of worship. Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nisa, لا خير في كثير من نجواهم إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس ومن يفعل ذلك ابتغاء مرضات الله فسوف نؤتيه أجرا عظيما. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying لا خير في كثير من نجواهم. What is النجوى? Word النجوى is conversation in secret between two people. So Allah is saying all these private conversations that people have secretly, most of it are not good. Most of it, most of the times that people are speaking together secretly is not good. He said, except if it is regarding three things. He said, إِلَّا مَنْ أَمَرَ بِصَدَقَةً. If you are taking somebody to the side to convince him to give a sadaqah or to give a charity, to support a poor person, to fix somebody's problem, right? He said, أَوْ مَعْرُوف. مَعْرُوف is taking somebody to the side to teach him something good from the deen, to speak to him about something to fix in himself, in his own actions, right? أَوْ إِصْلَاحٍ بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. Or we bring somebody to the side to talk to him, to fix his problem with somebody else. So these are the most righteous actions of worship. Whoever does that with sincerity, doing it for the sake of Allah and seeking the reward of Allah, Allah will give to him in the Day of Judgment a great reward. وَمَن يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ. So the one who will do these actions for the sake of Allah, he wants to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, فَسَوْفَ يُتِيهِ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah will give him a great reward in the Day of Judgment subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in hadith, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَلَا أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِأَفْضَلَ مِنْ دَرَجَةِ الصِّيَامِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَالصَّدَقَةِ. Do I tell you what is better than fasting and praying and giving charity? They said, yes, O Messenger of Allah, what is better than that? So the Prophet said, إِصْلَاحُ ذَاتِ الْبَيْنِ. To fix people's problems, to make settlements among people. And he said, فَإِنَّ فَسَادَ ذَاتِ الْبَيْنِ هِيَ الْحَالِقَةِ. So because the one who causes problems among the Muslims, he said, this is the shaver. The Prophet said, هِيَ الْحَالِقَةِ. حَالِقَة means the shaver. Then the Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, لَا أَقُولُ تَحْلِقُ الشَّعْرِ. The shaver, and I'm not saying the shaver that shaves hair. He said, I'm talking the shaver that shaves the deen. So imagine the one who causes problems among the Muslims, he is dividing the Muslims, making them to hate each other. His deen is getting shaved. His action is the shaver. And it shaves his deen. He's losing his deen the way the one who shaves his head is losing his hair. Subhanallah. And he said, وَلَكِنْ تَحْلِقُ الدِّينَ. So the Muslim is supposed to have a good manner. And good manner first with Allah. And if you have a good matter with Allah, if it is the call for the salah, you will honor that call. If you are able to go to the masjid, you perfect your wudu. You do it good, then you join the salah where you reflect in what you are reciting, Quran or the remembrance of Allah. When you bow, you perfect. When you prostrate, you perfect. Because you are in a meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even if you are not able to come to the masjid, wherever you pray, if you are praying home, perfect your salah. Do it in its time. Perfect your salah as if you are praying in the congregation. Not because you are praying by yourself, you make it fast and you don't pay attention to it and you don't perfect your salah. It is important to do it. This is part of your good manner. And part of your good manner, not only to treat people good, no, to fix the relationship with each other. Yeah, to that level. Not only to be good for people to have a good relationship with you, you are above that. You want to be good with people and want people to be good with each other. This is the perfect manners that Allah sent to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do. The job of the Prophet is what? The Prophet said, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. So the Prophet said, I was sent to perfect human manners. The first and the highest level is manners with Allah. To believe in Allah and to give Allah His right and to deal with Allah in a good manner. Right? So then, you give the Prophet his right by obeying the Prophet, respecting the Prophet, implementing his sunnah in your life. Then you be good with the Muslims. then you'll be good even with non-Muslims, right? So give everyone his right. This is the good manner. The Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, إِنَّ مِنْ خِيَارِكُمْ أَحْسَنُكُمْ خُلُقًا. The best of you, those who have good manner. And the Prophet also said in Sunan Abi Dawood, أَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقُهُ. يعني I guarantee house, I guarantee house in the highest level of Jannah to the one who is perfect in his manner. The one who is working on himself to be a person of good manner. So the one who is trying to be a person of good manner and he achieves that, the Prophet ﷺ guaranteed a house in the highest level of Jannah. So the way to be with the Prophet in the highest level of Jannah is to be a person of good manner. Start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be in good manner with Allah. Then be in good manner with your Prophet ﷺ. Then be in good manner with the Muslims and those who are closer, parents, teachers, this and that. And then even the non-Muslims, because when you show them your good manner, they will love Islam and they will be guided by the guidance of Islam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.